CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents...
Come in. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall. Somewhere in desolate, windswept space, in Twilight Land, in No Man's Land, two hurrying shades met face to face and bade each other stand. Space, Twilight Land, No Man's Land. You'll find it between the stars, in the frozen polar wastes, and inside the soul of every man.
You have to help us, Pappy!
You forget, I'm not Pappy. I'm not George Papadopoulos any longer. I've become something else.
You're still an officer in the United States Air Force. You took an oath to defend your country.
But I don't have a country anymore.
Your country is still the United States.
Why are you so excited? In just a little while, the United States will no longer exist.
Mystery drama, Arctic Encounter, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Sam Dan and stars Mason Adams. It is sponsored in part by True Value Hardware Stores and Buick Motor Division. I'll be back shortly with Act One. Silent polar wastes. Or are they wastes? These vast, illimitable prairies of snow and ice. It is said that beneath them lie the greatest riches of the earth, the oils, the metals, all the sinew and substance of modern civilization. And perhaps here are even hidden the ancient secrets of the planet itself. At any rate, the stillness is broken every day by the noise of the airplanes as they fly back and forth, looking, listening, charting, recording. The airplanes which show the white stars of our Air Force and the red stars of theirs.
Bunny Hutch calling White Rabbit.
This is White Rabbit, Bunny Hutch.
Location check.
Coordinates 34 and 16.
Activity?
Negative.
Roger.
Hey, Dawson. What's for chow at the base?
Oh, better you shouldn't ask.
Yeah, what's the movie they're showing?
Better you shouldn't know.
It's gonna be one of those nights, huh?
Roger. Get up.
Well, Pappy, another action-filled evening awaits us at the base.
You wanted action? You should have joined the Marines.
Bite your tongue. Besides, I'm not a fighter. I'm a lover.
Yeah, so I've heard.
It is true that on this assignment, I do not get to practice my avocation as frequently as I would prefer. However,
we must all make sacrifices for our country.
What are we doing up here inside this frosted over refrigerator, Pappy?
Ours not to reason why, Chappie.
Here we are, Pappy and Chappie, the Happiness Boys.
You remember the Happiness Boys?
I never even heard of them.
They were a team. Oh, 40, 50 years ago on radio.
Team?
Mm-hmm.
Ah, you have to be kidding. I just made that up.
No, it's true. I read all about them. Billy Jones and Ernie Hare. Snappy songs and patter. And there was Uncle Don.
Happy you never cease to amaze me.
This is Uncle Don, your Uncle Don. Hello, little friends, hello.
Where do you get all of this?
Research.
You are a very deep person.
What else is there to do up here but read? You had to try it, Chappie.
Well, I did try it. I actually read a book once. I wouldn't want to go through it again.
What time do you have?
1300 on the head.
That's what I thought. Well, I wonder where they are. What could have happened to Ivan?
Yeah, now that you mention it, what indeed?
You don't see him, do you?
Nope. At exactly 1300, he's supposed to be visible at 11 o'clock.
No sign of him. Should we report it?
Why should we?
Tell me honestly, if we were to spot him right now, would we report it?
Well, you know we would.
Okay, tell me why.
Well, you know why.
Tell me.
Because if we do spot Ivan, that's a happening.
And if we don't spot him?
That's a non-happening.
Well, I'll tell you who would disagree with that.
Who?
Sir Arthur Conan Doyle.
Well, now, don't bring your English friends into this thing.
He once wrote a story in which every night, this dog would bark. Now, you follow this?
It's not all that hard.
However, on this particular night, the dog did not bark.
He didn't?
He did not. Which is just as significant as what may be happening out here.
In what way?
Each day for the last 30 days on patrol, we fly by Ivan. Today, we don't. Why not?
Okay, why not?
I don't know. Could it be significant?
Let's throw it at Dawson. Maybe we can ruin his day. White Rabbit, calling the hutch.
This is Bunny Hutch. Come on in, White Rabbit.
I have an unusual occurrence to report.
Proceed, White Rabbit.
The dog did not bark.
Yeah?
That's it.
What's it?
That Spaskov two-motor observation plane we fly by over coordinates 3416 to 1300.
Mm.
Well, it's first time in 30 days and we haven't seen him. I thought you'd like to know.
I'm going
to
put you in for the Legion of Merit.
Thank you. Now, can you tell us a movie for tonight?
Sherlock Holmes in the Heart of the Baskervilles. This is Hutch, over and out.
Dawson, he must think we're crazy.
Look, in this outfit, if you're not crazy, you go crazy. What do you suppose did happen to Ivan today?
Well, it could have changed the patrol route.
I don't think so. Not till we do. The idea is to keep an eye on us.
Yeah, just like we're keeping an eye on them.
Naturally.
Maybe Ivan goofed and got themselves sent to Siberia.
From here? That would be a promotion.
Yeah. Let me tell you something about Ivan. One of them might be an Olga.
What's this?
If you listen real close to their messages, one of them sounds like a dame.
Dame with a deep voice.
Oh, they all got deep voices, those Olgas. I mean, they're built. Did you ever see pictures of them sweeping the snow off of the streets? Those are large ladies.
Well, on the other hand, some of them are frail and wispy, floating little ballerinas.
Yeah, I like mine somewhere in between.
So you think one of the Ivans is an Olga, huh?
You could win money on it.
Why you say that?
Instinct. Just let there be a dame within 1,000 miles.
Well, if she is, she's probably the only one.
I wonder how I could meet her.
Chappie, with all the dames that we have in the United States of America...
Now, Pappy, you're taking an isolationist, a chauvinistic point of view.
Oh, excuse me. I didn't mean to offend you.
Why are we here? To maintain peace.
Any fool knows that.
What better way to promote peace than for people to come together and really get to know each other? Now, you take this Olga. I bet she's just as anxious for a few laughs as we are. Yeah, I can see her now. Dark hair, black eyes. Oh, yeah. Yeah, it was always my type. Oh, God, we're such fools, you and I. Why are we being kept apart?
Don't tell me you're in love with her already.
How long do you think it takes, Pappy?
Chappie, take a look. Far distance.
What?
2 o'clock on the ground.
Yeah?
What do you think it is?
What do I think? What? Ooh.
Check it through the glasses. That's not my imagination, is it?
No, that's something all right.
Let's have a good look.
It looks like a plane.
Not in one piece, either.
It's Ivan, all smashed up.
It's a Spaskov two-motor.
It must have come down hard, too. Do you think anyone's alive there?
No, there's something funny going on. We should have heard a distress signal.
Maybe he didn't have a chance.
If he's down, it's a cinch. He's missed out on a checkpoint. His base should be trying to reach him.
I don't hear a thing.
Call the hutch. Tell them what we got.
I sure hope Augur's okay. White Rabbit, calling the Bunny Hutch. Come in, Bunny Hutch. Bunny Hutch?
What's the matter?
I can't raise the bass. Come in, Bunny Hutch. This is White Rabbit.
Hey, the light's on.
What the?
The radio's dead.
But how? What?
Chappie, we're losing power.
What's going on?
Everything's out.
We're going down.
Chappie, he's back on her. Back.
What's happening, Pappy? What's going on? Pappy. Pappy.
Yeah.
You okay?
I don't know. I feel kind of numb. How's the plane?
I think we're in one piece.
Well, that's something. I suppose there's any point asking about the radio.
You can ask.
Well?
Everything's out. And I can't get anything started.
How could we lose all our power?
I don't know. It's as if...
As if what?
As if somehow suddenly it all just drained out. I know that sounds crazy.
What can we do?
I don't know.
I don't either. Just asking to pass the time.
Poppy, is anything broken?
I don't think so. I just feel nothing.
Can you move?
Yeah, maybe if you help me. The question is, where would we go?
Well, we just have to sit tight.
Yeah, provided that we don't...
We're not going to freeze.
Without power, we can't make any heat in here.
Now, look, we got these lanterns in the emergency locker. That's what they're for, to give heat. There's plenty of blankets and some food.
How far do you figure we're from base?
Oh, 250 miles. We can hold on.
Yeah.
In about an hour, they'll be out looking for us.
Wonder how Ivan's doing.
I'm going to go look. Now, let's get those heat lanterns going first.
Happy. How do you account for the fact we both came down in exactly the same spot?
I don't know.
There a reason?
I don't know.
There is such a thing as coincidence, but... Suppose it isn't a coincidence. Then what?
Well, then, it's one for the deep thinkers, which lets me out. All right, I think I got the lamps burning. Things will be nice and warm when I come back in.
Nice and warm. Be lucky if we can hold the temperature above freezing.
Well, that's cozy for this neighborhood. Hold the fort.
Now, listen, don't stay out there too long. Just a quick look and back. It's 70 below out
there. You know what they say. It's a nice, dry cold.
Be careful.
Why? What could happen? Boy, it's cold. How do you get this thing open? The door should swing it. It's jammed. Boy, I don't see how anybody could be. Hey! Oh, it's Olga. Olga, hold on. I'll get you loose from there. Come on. Now, Olga, listen, do you speak, what's the word? Panemaya English, Olga?
English?
Ah.
Yes.
Yeah, are you okay, Olga?
Yes.
Good.
Oh, Dimitri.
Who?
Dimitri, the navigator, Dimitri Denisova. Where is Dimitri?
I don't know. I don't see anyone else.
But
maybe he went for help.
How? Where?
Well, I don't know. But he isn't here.
He was hurt. I heard him. He could not have gone.
But he is gone. I mean, the way you must have come down and the shape the ship is in, you're lucky to be alive. Can you move?
Yes. Okay.
Now listen. By any chance, would your radio be working?
Radio? No. All here is dead. All power is, how do you say in English, kaput.
Yeah. Well, that's just great.
Great?
I was hoping we could use your radio to call for help.
Help?
Yeah, we need help.
But I do not understand. Are you not the help?
Oh, no. You see, we're in the same fix that you are. We lost all our power, too.
Oh, you lost the power?
Yeah, everything. It just died on us. I guess the same thing must have happened to you.
You lost the power?
That's what I'm telling you.
Then it is true.
What's true?
The rumor.
What kind of rumor?
There is something out here.
Yeah? Well, what about it?
Something that will destroy us all.
Well, we've been looking at the world in terms of absolutes. We and they. We and they dominate the core of every dispute. We and they are the two superpowers. Each of us can unleash the forces that can completely destroy the world. Now, is there a third party that has dealt himself, or which has dealt itself, a hand in the game? We'll play Showdown in Act Two. Forbidding north, the wasteland of snow and ice. And yet, man has ever been drawn there. But unlike the forests that can be cleared and the deserts that can be watered, the north will always resist and reject us. Nothing of ours can take root or hold fast. The north, indifferent, implacable, ready to make of each visitor a victim.
It is said something is here that can destroy us all.
Sure, but that's old stuff. Cold, exposure, starvation.
No. Something.
All right. What? What is it?
I do not know. It is a rumor.
Who started it?
Who? Who starts rumors? Do you not have rumors in your Air Force?
Oh, sure. Lots of them.
Can you tell? Do you know who starts those rumors?
Sure. I do.
You?
Sure. I have to do something for a laugh.
Yes, but this is not a rumor to have fun.
No. So what kind of rumor is it?
Something is here that will kill all life.
What?
They say something from out there.
Out where?
The stars.
Space?
Space, yes, yes, space.
Whew. Well, why not?
Oh, you believe?
I'm ready to believe anything.
They say it landed here, or fell here.
It could very well be.
Oh, you will not say to anyone I said it to you.
Ah, mum's the word.
I have told a secret.
It's safe with me.
Nichevo.
What does that mean?
It means it does not matter. Nothing will now matter.
Oh, come on. I admit things appear to be somewhat bleak. However, let us look at the bright side.
We shall not leave here alive.
Don't say that.
It is true.
Now, don't say that. I mean, my outfit, your outfit, they know pretty much where we are.
No. Nothing can save us.
Look. The cold is starting to bite through. We'd better get over to my ship.
But you have no power.
Yeah, we've got lanterns, we've got blankets, we've got food.
And soon it will be gone.
Hopefully, by that time.
A few more hours of life. Yes, we shall cling to a few more hours of life.
You better help me swing the door shut. The lamps are out.
The fuel. It must be gone.
No, it's only been a couple of minutes, and there was plenty. Wait a minute. Pappy? Pappy?
Pappy?
George Papadopoulos, my pilot. He's gone.
Gone?
Pappy! Pappy, where are you?
He went perhaps to look for you.
He knew where I was going.
Oh.
Besides, he was hurt. He couldn't move.
Like Dimitri.
Do you have a weapon?
A revolver.
I've got a .45.
What good?
I don't know. Let's see if we can get the lanterns going before it gets too cold in here.
No, they cannot. They cannot burn.
Why not?
You see, they are not burning now.
Well, they could have gone out by some fluke or accident.
They will not light again.
We can try. First, you have to pump this gadget here. Hey, there isn't any fuel. But the tanks were full.
Yes, yes. It is the something that is out here.
We're on that again, huh?
It must be something that eats fuel and energy.
Olga, we have to raise the base. Your place or mine. That's a laugh.
What is?
Well, what I just said, your place or mine.
Why is that a joke?
Well, it's funny because of the circumstances.
Yes?
It's all right. Maybe one day I can explain it.
No, explain now. This is the only day. An hour, 2 hours. We will freeze.
Olga, somehow we are going to get that radio started.
No.
We'll figure a way.
We must not.
We must not?
We must not try to fix radio.
But why?
Because if so, we will call for help.
Well, sure. That's the idea of the thing.
We must not call for help.
What, you mean we should freeze to death? Starve?
Why have you fallen from sky?
Because we saw your ship on the ground.
Yes. And when you came near, what happened?
We crashed.
Yes. This something that destroys our plane destroys also yours. Now will come other airplanes to find us both. And when they see us and come close, then this something makes them crash also.
Yeah. Well, we wouldn't be able to fix the radio anyhow. What is this something?
Oh, who can say?
And we might have had a beautiful friendship.
No.
No? Why no?
You are not a serious person.
And I take it you are?
Oh, yes. Very serious. You are, what word do I want? Frivolous.
That's right. That's absolutely true.
You admit, then?
Yeah, that's why we'd be so good for each other.
We have 1 hour, 2, maybe 3 hours to live. Should we talk this way?
Why not?
So personal?
Well, what else should we be talking about?
We should have discussion on, you would call it dialectical materialism.
All right. Dialectical. Why begin.
Nietzsche.
Yeah, my sentiments exactly. Olga, listen.
I have to say something. My name is not Olga.
You didn't?
No. I am called Praskovia.
Ah.
Praskovia Alexandrovna Sorokin.
You want me to call you whatever that is?
No. It's better Olga.
My name is Stuart Maitland Chapman III, but you can call me Chappie.
Chappie?
It's close enough.
I am honored to make your acquaintance.
I can see your eyes are blue. But underneath your helmet, what color is your hair?
Blonde.
Yeah. When I think of what might have been.
What might have been?
Had we met under different circumstances.
But under different circumstances, how could we have met?
Yeah, I guess that's part of the problem. We had to have a disaster. Well, what are we going to do about it?
Do?
We can sit here, maybe hold hands, and wait till we freeze to death. Or...
Yes. Or...
Or we can fight it.
Fight what? Who?
Whoever and or whatever is doing this to us.
How?
I was afraid you'd ask me that. Look. What made both our ships come down? What robbed us of all of our fuel, of our energy?
Something. A something?
All right, okay. Let's try to find that something and destroy it or shut it off.
But where is it?
And where is your man Dimitri and Pappy? I mean, what could have happened to them?
I am cold.
Yeah, we're starting to feel it. And it won't get better. Look, while we can still move, while we can still care, do you want to try to go out there and find it? Fight it or whatever?
Yes. How quiet. How still. There's not even a wind.
Nope, just cold. And the cold is enough.
Oh, the silence. It frightens you.
Honey, Everything out here scares the daylights out of me.
No, Choppy. You are brave. Yeah,
crazy describes it better.
Oh, Choppy.
What is it?
My hand.
Your hand?
The wrist.
What's wrong?
A feeling. Pins.
What?
Pins. Many pins. 100 pins. 1,000. Sticking at my wrist.
No, no. Don't take your glove off.
My wrist.
If you expose any part of your skin.
But the pins.
Do you have a wristwatch?
Yes.
Now move back. Move back here. Quickly.
I.
Is it better?
Yes. Yes.
Now move back further. Okay. How does it feel?
The pins. They are no longer. It is gone.
Okay, now we know for sure. It's something. It goes for metal, for fuel, for energy. For, I guess, anything. Everything.
Choppy. Blue. Thing.
What?
In front of you. 20 meters. A thing. It is like a...
It's like a... Like a box.
Yes.
But it isn't blue. It's turning red.
Choppy, I feel warm.
Yeah, so do I.
It means we begin to freeze.
No, it isn't that kind of warm. It's not like you feel pleasant and drowsy.
It is hot.
Why should we feel hot?
Does it have anything to do with that thing?
It becomes more and more red, as if it burns.
That thing? It's causing everything that's happening. Must be a piece of machinery of some kind. What do you think?
Yes.
Well, maybe there's a switch. Maybe there's a way to shut it off.
No, you cannot go near.
I'll have to.
No, Choppy, return.
Oh,
Choppy.
The needles. I feel needles sticking.
Return. Return, Choppy, return.
Oh.
It is what I felt, no?
Yeah. Yeah. Oh,
it has gone, the pain.
Well, I guess you can only get so close and then... Wait a minute.
Hmm?
Wait a minute. Maybe we can destroy it.
How?
We'll have to do it from here. You've got a revolver.
Hmm?
I have a .45. Let's shoot at it.
But what if...
Yeah? What if what?
I do not know.
Honey, what have we got to lose? Are you a good shot?
I am expert.
Here goes.
What the...
Don't shoot, Chappie. Don't shoot.
What? It's Pappy.
Don't shoot.
Hold your fire, Olga. Hold your fire. Pappy? Is that you?
It sounds like Pappy. Whatever did happen to him anyhow... But as our friends look in every direction, there is absolutely no sign of Lieutenant George Papadopoulos or of Captain Dmitri Andreev either. There is only the endless frozen waste, the shattered remains of the two military observation planes, and a box, which first appeared to be blue, but now is glowing a fiery red. This is the picture. Hold it in mind for the next few minutes. And then we shall return with Act 3. As I was going up the stair, I met a man who wasn't there. He wasn't there again today. I wish he'd stay away. Well... Lieutenant George Pappy Papadopoulos, United States Air Force, is definitely not there. And while Lieutenant Stuart Maitland Chapman doesn't exactly see him, he hears him, which can be classified as the same basic type of problem. All right?
Don't shoot, Olga. Don't shoot. Is that you, Pappy?
Yes. Yes, it is me.
Where are you?
That's a good question.
Well, do you have a good answer?
I have an answer. I don't know how good it is. On the other hand, good or bad, I'm not sure those are distinctions that matter too much anymore.
Pappy, don't try to kid the troops. This is me you're talking to.
I'm aware of that.
What's the drill?
I'm a part of it.
You're part of what?
It's hard to explain.
Yeah, but it's not impossible. Where are you?
Obviously, I'm here.
I was right, Pappy. One of the Ivans was an Aga.
Yes. And the other one is called Dimitri.
Aga, where's his voice coming from?
From... Oh, it cannot be.
From where, Aga?
Her name isn't Olga. It's Praskovia.
Right now, that's not the problem. From where, Aga?
It comes from the box.
That's what I thought. Are you in there, Pappy?
Yes.
It cannot be. It is impossible.
His voice. It must be a tape.
Dimitri told me all about her.
Pappy, what is this?
I'm trying to explain it. This is a thing.
What kind of thing?
Like, you could call it a world.
What do you mean? A world.
A world. Like the one you live on.
You said a world like the one we live on?
Right.
Does that mean it's another one?
Yes. You could say that.
Oh, Pappy, for crying out loud.
Choppy, you must be calm.
You realize he's my best friend and I can't understand a thing he's talking about.
Why is so difficult? A world. Another world, so?
Where is it, Pappy? Where is it and where are you?
The box.
The box?
What do you think this box is?
Well, it looks like...
It looks like computer from Sputnik.
That's right.
A Sputnik?
A satellite.
Ours or theirs?
I don't know. It doesn't matter. It was dead.
It dead?
Yes. It just floated in space until...
Well?
Until this wandering world...
What wandering world?
Well, it's a kind of...
A kind of what?
I'm looking for a word to describe it.
I must be crazy. I'm hearing things.
Intelligence. That's the word.
A world of intelligence?
Yes.
Well, what kind of a world is that?
Just thoughts, ideas.
What kind of thoughts and ideas?
Everything. All kinds of images and fancies.
And what else?
Nothing else.
Nothing else? I mean, that's enough to make up a whole world?
Yes.
She understands.
Our world is ideas. But to support ideas, we need, how do you say, physical bodies.
Another world. Another civilization.
I still don't understand it.
This is a world of pure intelligence. It doesn't need bodies. It's evolved far beyond that point.
But you haven't told me where it is.
Yes, I did. It's in that box.
The whole world? In that small box?
How much space do you need for an idea?
How did it get here?
The satellite was in space. It attracted this floating world.
Yeah? Why?
Because...
Why?
I think this is something he doesn't want to tell us.
I will tell you. Because it doesn't make any difference now. The world, this world, it needs nourishment. And...
I think I know where you're headed, Pappy.
And it takes its energy wherever it can find it. It floats or wanders or prowls through space and feeds on anything it can turn into mental energy.
How did it get here?
The satellite died and it fell and landed. The world, my world.
Your world?
Yes, Jappy, I'm part of it now.
But you're an American.
Oh, I'm part of a different world.
Well, what are you doing?
Well, what are you doing? You're living. The same thing with us. We live. That is, we try to maintain life just as you do.
Don't say we and you like that.
But it is we and you now. We seek sustenance, nourishment, just as you do.
Oh, come on, Pappy. It's all a joke. It's a big gag.
No, it isn't.
There's a punchline. There has to be a punchline somewhere.
We feed on energy. All energy, animal, vegetable, mineral, just as you do.
Can you understand him, Aga?
Yes, I believe I understand.
And what we consume, what we are nourished by, becomes a part of us. Adding to us another intelligence. The difference between us is that what nourishes you becomes a part of your body. nourishes us becomes a part of our intelligence.
Are you telling me this thing, this intelligence, this world killed you?
No. It saved me.
Saved you?
I was dying. So was Dimitri. So when it came, I couldn't resist. The way you can, still.
What do you mean, still?
You see, the intelligence that I'm part of is nourished now. All the energy from the two planes, from Dimitri, from me. It is filled with fire, creative fire. Even you can feel the glow. But soon we will need more. And from hot red, we shall recede into cold blue. And then?
Yes, then?
Then you will become weak. From hunger. From cold. And you will not have the strength. You will also become part of this world.
No.
It isn't bad. Not at all.
We have to fight you, Pappy.
How? How can you fight me?
Olga, we have to get out of here. Do you understand?
Yes.
In a few hours, my base, yours, will send out search planes. Those planes, if they fly by here, they'll be brought down by this thing.
We must not be here.
They must spot us away from the range of this thing.
How far can you go, Chappie? How far in this cold? A mile?
He's right, but we have to do something.
Yes, but what?
It doesn't matter. Soon you'll be one of us.
Us.
Be grateful. We will save your life.
Oh, sure.
Instead of dying of the cold, you'll be rescued by our world. You'll be part of the intelligence. I would have died. Dimitri would have died.
No.
There's nothing you can do about it in any event, Chappie. You see how the red is fading? Soon we will need more energy. You will become colder and weaker.
And the others?
What others?
You know what others. Your old buddies, the guys in your outfit.
I no longer have an outfit. Why can't you understand
that? They'll fly by. They'll see the wrecks. They'll come in closer. They'll be trapped and destroyed just as we were.
Not destroyed. Just changed.
Olga, can you think of something? What can we do?
Chappie, do you realize this is the first time in your life you ever asked a woman for advice?
Well, maybe she's the first one I ever met who I felt like asking.
Why do you think you can ask me?
Well, because... Oh, come on.
Tell me.
Well, it's because... Well...
I understand. It is difficult for you to say it.
Maybe.
It's difficult for me also.
What's going to happen to us?
Nothing. You'll both blend into this one great intelligence. You'll be part of this world.
No. Oh,
Chappie, it is getting cold.
It is.
See, the box is now turning blue.
Olga, we have to do something.
Oh, let us sit close to each other and wait.
Wait for what?
Oh, Nichevo.
No. No, we have to fight. Pappy.
Yes.
Come on, Pappy. You have to help us fight this thing.
Chappie, I am this thing.
No, not you. You're Lieutenant George Papadopoulos, the most popular guy in the 199th Squadron.
No.
You can't drop it like that. Your friends, your country. I mean, you can't cast them aside like a snake gets rid of a skin. You took an oath.
You don't understand.
What's there to understand? A guy betrays his country. That's clear enough. And it's bad enough. But you're even worse.
Don't say that, Chappie.
Don't you call me Chappie. That's for my friends. Lieutenant Chapman to you. I'll tell you why you're worse. It's not just your country you're selling down the river, but it's humanity. It's your own kind of people.
Listen to me. This is a whole new...
A whole new nothing. You say every world is a world of ideas. Well, you're right. But your ideas belong to this world. The stuff you grew up with, your friends, your family, the Air Force.
Chappie.
You know I'm right. All those memories, all the things you like, the happiness boys, Uncle Don and Sherlock Holmes.
Chappie, don't. I can't help you.
You have to.
They won't allow it.
They?
Me, the rest of me, the part that was once them, is trying to stop me.
Is there anything that we can do?
Yes.
Tell us. Just tell us.
I'm being drowned in the... They're taking the words from me.
What words?
The words I can't tell you.
Try, Chappie.
Those words are gone. And remember the first thing I said to you.
Pop, first thing he said to me? What was the first thing he said to me? We met at the base and he said to me, "What's your name, sport?" That's what he said.
What's your name, sport? What is sport? Oh, athletic, no?
That's not what he means. But it's the first thing he ever said to me.
No, not the first thing he ever said, but not the first thing he said now.
First thing he said, don't shoot, Choppy, don't shoot.
He's right. But why? Why don't shoot? Because shoot can hurt. Destroy, maybe, the box.
Hurry, before it gets too cold to hold the gun. Hurry!
Chappie?
I think you're going to be all right. You were picked up before the frost could really get you.
Olga.
The girl? Well, actually, her outfit landed the same time we did. They took her, we took you.
Listen to me. There was this thing from space somewhere. It lives on energy. It drained all the power from the engines, the radio, from everything.
Uh-huh.
Don't look at me like that. That's why we crashed.
You crashed because you had a power failure.
How do you account for Ivan?
Well, I guess he must have had one, too.
Isn't that maybe just too much of a coincidence?
Life's made up of coincidences.
Okay. Poppy. Why couldn't you find Pappy?
Well, he must have wandered off.
And Ivan. What was his name? Dimitri. Did he wander off, too?
It's the only explanation.
Look, I am trying to give you the real explanation. Did you find a blue box?
Sure. It was a broken old computer housing from a space satellite.
Lawson, I am trying to explain to you.
Chappy, I'm trying to explain to you. Leave well enough alone.
When it has to do with space and phenomena of that nature, the official reply is always a rather evasive, "Let well enough alone." Officially, there are nothing but denials when questions of space, UFOs, the Bermuda Triangle, are brought into question. The powers that be seem to ascribe them all to the imaginings of well-meaning but deluded folk, like you and me. I'll be back shortly. Wondering whatever became of Lieutenant Stuart Maitland Chapman and Praskovya Alexandrovna Sorokin, or, if you will, Chappie and Olga. You can understand how difficult it would be for them even to encounter each other again, much less engage in a courtship. This, of course, shows most poignantly that the greatest distances are not in outer space, but right here, between one side of a frontier and the other. If you're a romantic and want to believe they surmounted all the considerable problems and got together, why then, believe it, with my blessing. Our cast included Mason Adams, Mandel Kramer, and Bryna Rayburn. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by Buick Motor Division and True Value Hardware Stores. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.